Hello everybody, I'm Scotty from Scotty's Clock World. Thanks for joining me back on my channel. Both the springs are contained now. As you can see, they've both got a mainspring clamp on them. That is definitely not easy work to do without a proper letdown tool on them. I might actually have to make one, modify this little piece here that works so well, and put it into a handle that I can hold it and let it slide down more easily and more evenly. All right, they're contained. Now we'll start to take off some of the front pieces of the movement. First up, we'll have to remove this piece here. It's actually got a piece of bent wire in it. Open that up a bit with a screwdriver, give us a bit of a chance to take it out. Want you a little bit more, that's looking all right. See if I can straighten that up a tiny bit. And where's our big... Not quite enough yet, and I don't think this dentist probe will pull it out either. Nope, it's got to be a little bit straighter. All right, where's our pliers? Actually, what we'll do, we'll nip that end off because we're going to have to replace that piece of wire anyway, so I'll nip that off. Get a grip on it. Ah, that's better. There we go. Now we're going to have to remove that mangled taper pin that holds that wheel on, and at the same time it's part of the alarm mechanism. You can see that spring there lifting it up and down, and a slot in it there where when it turns round, it activates the alarm. All right, we'll take that out. Naturally, it's not in an easy position to remove, but it's pretty hard to get out. I think it's tight on the other side too. However, it has to come out for us to get these other wheels off. Might have to get a pair of pliers with teeth on them, that I can get a grip on that. We'll keep that tapered pin aside. We'll have to make a new one so we know where it comes from. And in actual fact, for the moment, I'll put this wheel with it. It'll still go into the ultrasonic cleaner, but that'll remind me where that pin comes from. Own little dish, lovely. All right, now what have we got? Motion works, the minute wheel comes off also. So that's got those two off. All right, now we'll look at the other side and start taking pieces off there, because that's the side that's got the four nuts on it that hold it together. Once again, we're gonna have to find a... Ooh, that's a tiny little bit big. I'll have to look for a smaller wrench for that, and that's too small at 4. Let's try 5. All right, 5 mil it is. So that's the size we need when we get down to taking those off. All right, now let's have a look at this and see what we start taking apart first. Spring's looking a little bit rough. We'll have to flatten that out before we put it back in. Now, another one of my little wrenches, and that's too... No, that fits perfectly well. All right. First up, we'll take the pin out. That holds the hairspring. That might require a pair of pliers for a bit more bite, I think. Right, that's got him out. Now, very carefully, lift the hairspring out from there, and then remove it from this piece here, which is the time adjustment fast slow on it. All right, that's out. All right, now we're going to take the balance wheel out, put the hairspring on it. So what we'll do, we'll start undoing this nut here. Getting there slowly, so here we go. We've just loosened him now. See if it's loose enough to take that out, and it is. And naturally one of the coils on the spring would be caught on something, but we caught that before we did any damage. There we have the hairspring. Look how blunt that tip is. We'll have to redefine that tip before we put it in. The top tip's not too bad, it's still pretty pointed, but that is anything but pointed. You can see the hairspring. I'll hold it in the other hand, that makes it easier. You can see the hairspring. That is supposed to be aligned with the rest of the hairspring down there, but this coil's way out of whack. Right, put that aside and I'll put that in its own container so we don't make any more of a mess of it than it is at the moment. Put that in there. Cap on it, out of the road. Well, that's all right, that's done. Now we'll have a look at the rest. We put that in there. We can have a look and see what the next step is. Right, we'll take this spring off. These little screws, being careful not to lose it. And the spring. Them aside, and we'll also take this one here off. This is a select lever for the loud or intermittent alarm. Right, and that's about it for the moment. I'm charging up my battery, then I'll come back again. I'll remove the time setting hand, pull that off, gone. Now I think we're ready to take the top plate off. Everything else on there I think can stay on there. And see if we've got our little wrench happening. Yep, little spanner's working all right. Loosen those off. And that one's a bit tight. Oh, got him. Try this guy up here again. Nope, different size, all right. We'll use our shifting jawed spanner and get him loosened up. That's about, yep, that seems to be right. Get our dish ready to put the nuts in. We'll take them off the pillars that hold the movement plates together. pop them in the dish. And then very carefully start to lift the plate up. And see what happens. Something. No, that should be right. No, that'll look all right. That looks like it should come up, but it's caught on. There we go. How good was that? Everything stayed in place, nothing jumped out. Excellent. Well, I'll take a photo of that before we start, because I haven't seen one of these movements in this configuration before. So that way, I should in theory have a vague idea how to put it all back together again. It's always a good idea if you're working on a movement that you haven't seen before or one you're unfamiliar with, to take a few photos to help you put it back together again. I'll start off by removing the hammer. Interesting. Looks like that should be sitting on an escape wheel. Now what do we got? We'll take these out and put them into our foam block. That's a bit tight. There's a little bit of tension in there, not much, but a little bit. Right, we'll start off with this guy. Should slide out underneath, thank you. First one. Then that one. This wheel here transmits the power from that spring. That there. Now, the bits to be very careful of. Pin pallet. The escape wheel with its tiny little teeth on it. Take that one out. And that one. And that guy, I think, is going to stay there. He's got a tension clutch on him. But I'll have a look and see. We may be able to lift that up. We should be able to lift it up. See what I can see, how tight it is. No, that's very tight. All right, we'll see if we can remove spring from underneath it. I don't know that we can, but we'll give it a go. Is there we go, slides out the side. Put that over there. Try this one also. If we can lift it up a little bit. That is very tight. Ah, not surprised it's very tight. Got a taper pin in it. Right, we'll have to take that out first. Right, pair of pliers. Oh, a bit bent too, so. Pair of pliers, we'll remove that. That's definitely on the replace list when that comes out. Oh dear. I'll bend that down a little bit and see if that makes a difference. Probably not a lot, but all right, we'll give it a squeeze then if that's the case, if it's going to be hard to get on with. Oh, still getting hard to get on with. There we go. See what I mean about we need a new one of those. Now, lift that little wheel off and get in underneath it. Good, look at the oil in there. That is seriously, there we go. Wet and oily, and that'll drop off in a moment, but we'll pick it up. Now we can get dropped out, just heard it there. Now we can get this other spring out of the way, I would think. It should be, yeah, there we go. There he is, the other spring. They seem to be in pretty good nick, actually. A bit oily, but other than that, they seem to be in pretty good nick. That's the other one. All the coils are equidistant running around. There's no dints or anything in them, all right. We'll check those when we take them apart. Now, that's what's left of our plate. You can see it's very oily there. All that glistening down there. And, of course, heaps of it there. Right, we'll give that a wipe before it goes into the ultrasonic. And I'll get this other. There we go. We've got that out. And I think that that is a special wheel so that you can't wind the spring too tightly, because if you look at it, you will notice that those five teeth there are shorter than that one there. Or more importantly, that tooth there is longer than those five. And that we'll wedge into, I think it's that one there, wedge into there, which will stop it winding too far. We'll investigate that when we get back to it. All right, we're ready to start getting things sorted for the ultrasonic cleaner now. We're starting to get the parts organized, put in the ultrasonic cleaner. There's the winding keys in that little tea strainer container. In this one here, we've got the pin pallet and the escape wheel, because they're pretty small, we don't want them to get damaged. And this one here, that's a part of the alarm mechanism that we took off the front of the movement. Tighten that up. I'll get rid of these chains that are hanging on here. We don't need those. Straight into the bin. And in this little tea strainer here, we've got the nuts that hold the plates together on the pillars, and those couple of wheels that we took off before. So first up, what we'll do, I'll turn this round a bit, we'll do those pieces there. I'll cut a bit of wire, pretty thin wire, so I'll double it over, or thereabouts. First piece, motion works, with the hour wheel on it. Then we'll tighten that down a little bit, it's a bit too large for that to fit on. Where's our pliers? Wind that down. Okay, if not, we'll just put it up in there. That's easily done. That's a minute wheel. Right, twist those two together. They're ready. Now these three pieces here are pretty large. They're not going to fall through any holes in the ultrasonic cleaner, so I won't worry about putting them together. I will tie these other two together. They got pretty decent size holes and gaps in them, and that will fit in pretty well. Okay, they're ready to go. Put them there. Now, as I said before, we'll clean the excess oil off the plate. Bit over there. And relatively clean at the back because I've just done it both sides. See what we've got here. Any extra shiny pieces? No. All right. I think that's a press fit. That is a press fit. So if we... I think it's got a pin in it, but I'm not sure. Right, we'll leave that there. In the meantime, I'll take these other three levers off and we'll put them into the ultrasonic also. And I won't put this top plate in because it's got that timing mechanism for the alarm. I'm not taking a risk on that. All right, I'll take those off and then put them into the ultrasonic, and then I'll be back. Parts are now ready to go into the ultrasonic cleaner. I've been warming it up for a little while. We want it to be about 30 degrees before we put the parts in. So they're now ready to go. I'll do that. I'll clean them up outside in some cold water, then some warm water, then immerse them in lighter fluid, dry them off, and then run over them with a heat gun on low to make sure that all the lighter fluid has been removed. All right, back in a moment.